Have you ever wanted to play mobile games on PC using an emulator? Well, actually, there is a very simple program you can install, set it up, and you can play every single mobile game that is out there that is supported by Android or is on Android, and you can play it on PC, no problem, no lag, no nothing, even if you have a mid-tier PC. So let's go into the video. But before that, I just want to say that I do stream on Twitch every single day except Sundays. If you do want to check me out, I do stream a lot of different games. So if you do want to stop in, link is down in the description below. I would love to see you there. Now, how do we set up an emulator to play mobile games on PC? First, what we need to do is just download one simple program, which is called BlueStacks. Once we download BlueStacks, we can go over and show you how to set everything up. I'm gonna go there right now and show you how to install it first. Okay, so now that we are on the BlueStacks website, I will link this website down in the description below as well. It's just bluestacks.com. A lot of people use this program, and it's you can see right here, it's backed by Intel, AMD, Qualcomm, and a bunch of other huge companies as well. So you know it's legit. It's not a virus or anything like that. Apparently, it supports iOS as well. I haven't really tried that. I've only tried Android games, so it might work for iOS as well. There is a lot of different versions of the program itself, and there is also cloud. So you can also play the games on cloud, which means that you don't even have to download them or install them. It just works by opening the game and that's it. I haven't tried cloud yet, but you can try it out if you want. It's currently in beta as well. You can see a lot of different things on the website as well. Play instantly, no download, no installation. That's for cloud. And then a lot of different games over here that you can actually play. So if we go to the website and we click on see all versions, we can actually see a bunch of other versions as well. There's BlueStacks 5 and there's BlueStacks 4. I've used BlueStacks 4 personally for like 6 months or even more. It worked no problem at all. I had zero issues. BlueStacks 5, like, it recently came out and it's pretty new. I haven't really tried it out too much, so I can't tell you if it has a lot of bugs or not. But if you have any issues with BlueStacks 5, you can check out number 4, and then that one should work no issues at all. This one is also optimized for Windows 11. So if you want to check it out, just click download. It's going to install BlueStacks 5, and then I will show you how to set it up, no problem. Common issue for BlueStacks is actually blue screen of death. So if you try to install the program and then your PC crashes and everything shuts down and you're panicking, like, what is going on? Did I just break my PC? It's really simple to fix it as well. I will link this article from the official support as well. I had the issue where my PC blue screened and I was panicking as well. I didn't know what to do. All you gotta do is enable virtualization on Windows. So it's in BIOS. All you have to do is go to BIOS, enable virtualization. That basically makes it so you can run emulators and duplicate the screens from the mobile devices basically. So that way your PC can actually support them. So over here, you have the whole support that shows you how to do it. It's really easy. You have to scroll down to the Intel or AMD CPU, depends on what CPU you have. I have AMD. You go click on one of these. It's going to just go to the website. And then you go to the BIOS, you go to advanced mode. And then over here, you go to advanced. And then you will see CPU configuration. And then you just need to enable SVM mode. That is for AMD CPU. It's really simple. You enable SVM mode, you click on save, and that's pretty much it. It's not complicated. It's really simple. Everyone can do it. If you want to do it for Intel CPU, you click on Intel, and then you go again, advanced, advanced, and then CPU configuration. And then you will see over here, Intel virtualization technology. You just need to enable that as well. So that's the same thing, just different CPU, so it works the same way no matter what CPU you have. So now that we have our BlueStacks installed, if we open it up, it's going to show up the program itself over here. We can have all these different apps and all these different things. We have a Play Store as well. So you can download every possible game that is on Play Store, any possible app that is on Play Store. You just click on Play Store itself. It's going to open it up. You need to log into your Play Store email, obviously, so don't worry about it. It's, again, legit, no worries. And then you can see right here, you have a bunch of different games, just like you have it on the phone. I'm pretty sure it emulates a Samsung phone as well. So every game that is on Samsung, I'm pretty sure it's like S21 or S20, it will be able to run on this too. So you have Bloons, TD Battles 2, you have Ark, You have Super Mario Run. We can click on Bloons, for example, click on this game, and then click on Install. Wait for the download, and then the game will download instantly, basically. And then once it downloads, I can actually run it for you and show you how it works. And I'll show you that it actually works legit. If you click on Open, the game opens up. It says connecting to play games. And it's going to ask you for your gamer ID. So whatever you want to have your username as. I'ma be agent because I am always agent. And I'm going to choose this unicorn. Click on create. So now that you can see right here, I opened the game. Everything works. I don't want to play the game because I'm not really interested in it right now. But that's how you can run it. And that's how you can play it. So if you want to go home, you click on the home button. And you have the game installed over here. If you want to uninstall it, you do it the same way. Like you do for every Android app, you can go to system. You literally have a camera and settings and all of that stuff over here. You can literally go to settings and change whatever you want, like it is your phone. So this is on BlueStacks 5. BlueStacks 4 looks a little bit different, but it's pretty much the same. Even they said that BlueStacks 5 lowers your CPU usage to 90% even. So not sure how correct that is or how true that is. But if they're claiming that, it must be somewhat true. If you run a game and it doesn't have like special buttons or your half the buttons don't work, you can actually map everything normally. Like you over here, you go to game controls and you can choose a lot of these different keybinds on the side. You can assign special buttons. You can install APK files. So if the game is not on Play Store, but you have the APK version, you can install it like you can on the mobile phone. So just go to APK, download the APK on your PC, open it, and it's going to install it like it works through the phone as well. So you have a bunch of different things over here. You can play with it. You can shake your phone like you're shaking it for different apps. Set location. You have just everything and anything. And that's pretty much it and how to install BlueStacks and how to set it up. It's really simple, really easy program. A lot of people struggle with that blue screen of death. But all you gotta do is just install virtualization and it should be working, no problem. So that's how you set up BlueStacks. Hope you liked the video. If you did, make sure to drop a like, comment, and subscribe. If you do have any questions or you just wanna add a comment, make sure to do it down in the comments below. I'll try to help you out with some tips and tricks. And if you don't already know, I do stream on Twitch every single day except Sundays. Link is down in the description below. I would love to see you there. I stream a lot of different games and you can also chat with me live. Anyway, I'll see you in the next video. Peace out and have a good one. Bye-bye.